Odds are that if you are subscribed to this channel, and I hope you are, or you've been following me for a while, you know that I absolutely love using Lightroom to edit my photos. In fact, I consider the editing component of an image's life cycle to be as important as the composition and the exposure. The problem I sometimes run into, though, especially after editing photos for about 20 years, is that I don't always know the direction I want to take when it comes to the treatment that I want to apply. Sometimes I prefer something subtle, and other times I want to get a little bit funky. It really depends on the photo and my mood at the time. Another problem I've encountered is something I called sticky editing. That's when you get stuck in this editing routine and you end up making the exact same edits to all of your photos. Now, there's nothing inherently wrong with that if that's your intent. But I know that for me, there are times when I want to branch out a little bit and experiment with different treatments. And I bring this up because there is one little section in Lightroom that is an amazing cure for these two problems, and it's been hiding in plain sight. It's called Recommended Presets, and it's a game changer. Now, here's the thing. Recommended Presets is only available for Lightroom desktop, mobile, and web, not Lightroom Classic. So make of that what you will. With that, let's dive in. All right, so here I am in Lightroom desktop, and I think the best place to start is to explain the difference between a preset, which is accessible here. You can see it's the presets browser, and profiles, which can be accessible via the profile browser with this icon right here. And really the key difference is how the preset or the profile is created and what it does when you apply it to your photo. So a preset is basically a snapshot of the entire editing stack in Lightroom. So if I were to make changes to all or any of these individual sliders or curves or even the color grading, I can save that state of each of these different things into a preset. A profile is a little bit different though, because a profile doesn't really have anything to do with the editing stack in Lightroom. It's built atop what's called a lookup table or a LUT. And you can create LUTs using Photoshop or any other app that supports LUTs, for example, or at least saving LUTs. And then you can follow a process to turn the LUT into a profile that Lightroom recognizes. Now, I'm not going to go into detail with that right now. However, it's important to understand the difference between how a preset and a profile is created, but also what happens when you apply a preset or a profile to your photo. So the easiest thing is to just show you here. So let's go ahead here. I'll start with a profile. Notice how everything, for example, in the light section is currently zero. If I open up the profile browser here, and let's say I go to my own profiles that I have available on my website, I can hover over one of these here, like this number 3. I can click on it, and when I go back, you'll see that all of the sliders are still set to 0, but the image itself has changed. And that's because the profile kind of sits at the very top of the editing stack. Now I'm going to go ahead and just set this to Adobe Landscape, which is generally the profile that I use or start with when I edit a landscape photo. A preset, though, again, is a snapshot of your entire editing stack. So if I go to the presets browser here, and let's say I go to color grades. As I hover over here, let me show you something. I'm going to scroll down to color grades here. Now, let's say I apply just a random color grade like that. Now, watch what happens as I hover over. Do you see how the preset is going to overwrite the current state that I have? So I have a current state here in color grading. And as I hover over, if I click on a preset, it's going to actually overwrite. So that's one of the key differences in terms of how applying a profile differs from a preset. A profile will never adjust your editing stack. A preset will. So let's go ahead. I'm going to undo this, undo it again, just so that we're back kind of at a base level. Now, I mentioned how there is this kind of really awesome tool that's been hiding in plain sight. It's something that I've used for a little while, and I've been meaning to create a video about it. And I think you're going to love it. Now, again, this is only available in Lightroom desktop, which I'm showing you here, as well as Lightroom mobile and Lightroom on the web. And it's called Recommended Presets. So to access it, if we go ahead here and click on the presets browser again, you'll see there are 3 tabs at the top. There's yours, there's premium, and there's recommended, and that's what we're talking about here. Now yours, these are all the presets that you have imported or saved yourself. They're available over here. Premium is available for any paying Adobe Creative Cloud customer. So if you are not using the free version, if you're paying, you will have these categories here. And I mentioned how in a recent update to Lightroom, we also have this new adaptive blur background. This is a new category that was added. So it's nice to see that Adobe is actually updating this preset stack here. And there are some cool ones. Like if you kind of expand some of these, there are actually some cool presets worth your time. But actually this does allow me to illustrate even better. Notice here, the sliders are zero, but as I hover over, do you see how these presets are actually updating those sliders? So if I went ahead here and I had my own values and I applied a preset, the preset will overwrite them. So again, I just wanted to illustrate that really quickly one more time. All right, so that's premium. The real kind of headliner is this recommended. So what is that? Well, if I click on it, what Lightroom does is it analyzes the photo and then it pulls in presets that are being shared by people who are contributing to the Lightroom community. Now, Lightroom community is like its own secret cheat code for Lightroom. It is amazing, and it's only available for the new version of Lightroom. So if you want to see a video on that, leave a comment below. But again, it's presets that Lightroom thinks would be appropriate for this particular image that are created by members of the Lightroom community. Now let's just do a quick tour here. You can see there are categories along the top. We have all. All is basically a subset of presets from each of these categories. You'll have a little bit of each. So you'll have HDR, cinematic, bright, dark. There was warm, cool, black and white, strong, subtle, and all. So if I click on subtle, for example, it'll have subtle presets. Same thing with strong, and you get the picture. But here's the thing. As you hover over these, you'll get kind of a live preview of what the preset looks like. And so like, I actually like this one. And this is where recommended presets kind of is worth its weight in gold. Because when I look at this photo here, I would never think really to apply this kind of a treatment to the photo. But it kind of gets my creative juices flowing. And there are a few properties to a recommended preset that is not available on a regular preset. First, if you click on the ellipsis over here, you'll see a few different things. First, you'll see who created it. So in this case here, this preset was created by Cooper Mayberry. So Cooper, thank you for contributing to the Lightroom community. We all benefit from that. The other things you can do, you can save this to your preset. So if I want, I could just create a preset. It auto-populates with this name and the creator, which I think is awesome. Or I can go ahead here and save it as a version. Now I've got a video on how versions works. This is also one of the most underrated features in Lightroom. It is super powerful, so be sure to check out my video on that. And then of course, if you are kind of participating in the Lightroom community, you can choose to follow Cooper or you can view their profile. These are the things that you can do on Lightroom desktop. So you can see here, I clicked on this preset and it applied the edits. And so you can see that as far as this preset goes, it made changes to the light panel. It applied a parametric curve change. It made some color changes here. If we go further down, there's a very slight color grade applied over here and a few other things. You can see the texture was reduced to negative 100, which gives it that kind of soft focus look and so on. Point is that this is a pretty comprehensive preset. And like all kind of advanced presets, you have an amount slider, so you can dial this back. You can make it even stronger. Point is, I love how when you adjust the amount, you can actually see the sliders adjusting in real time. I think that is one of the coolest visuals. But that's not all. There is another amazing thing here. If you hover over the preset, you'll see this button that says more like this. And to me, this is where things get fun because let's say you have identified a preset that's like, oh, okay, like I didn't really think this was a direction I want to go. I kind of like it and I want to kind of go further down that rabbit hole. Well, I can click on more like this and the Lightroom will populate with additional presets that are kind of like it. Some of them will vary, but basically you can kind of find like this here. This is another really great preset. It's a little bit more subtle than this one. And so if I click over here, you can see that this is from Nomadic Dev. Again, thank you for your contribution. And again, you can save this as a preset or a version. But if I click on it, basically applies. And just like before, I can adjust the strength. Now, these recommended presets aren't just great for landscape photos. They will work on pretty much any type of photo you have in Lightroom. So if I go over to this next photo here, you can see Lightroom analyzes the photo. We're still in recommended here, and it gives me some options. Now, this is one of my older urbex photos. I used to love photographing urbex shots, like in abandoned schools and buildings, and I can have a lot of fun with presets here. Now, one of the things you can do here is you can click on auto. So I like to click on auto. This is a tone mapped HDR photo. I'll click on auto just to get an idea of what a general edit will look like. And then what I can do is kind of hover over these and find maybe if there's a preset that, I don't know, is kind of fun. Like this one's actually kind of cool. And this one's also kind of cool. Let's see here. Actually, this one is kind of cool. I mean, literally, it's kind of a cool temperature, but I do like it. And what I'll do here is when I find something I like, I'll click more like this, like I showed you just before. And I can kind of hover over and see if there are other treatments. Like that's kind of funky. And when I find one that I like, usually what I'll do is I'll just save it as a preset just so that I have it. But I just love being able to explore. Now, you don't have to just use the similar ones. I can close this. You can see up here, it says similar to. That's kind of like a new filter. I can X that. And if I want, what I can do is go over to, say, cinematic. And this will show me all presets that are kind of classified as cinematic. So it'll take me in a different direction. Like, that's actually kind of cool. And just hovering over, remember, I can click on this and just kind of back off on the strength. But I like this one a lot. I think this is great. And you can see that there was this little bit of a tone curve applied, which I'm always a big fan of, as you know. And again, this gives me all these opportunities to go down these different rabbit holes creatively, to take different directions that I probably wouldn't have thought about if I was just left to my own devices. And of course, there are recommended presets for portraits. So I've used this photo in different videos before, and it just is a cool way to illustrate to you, like here, this is just a nice little punch up for the photo, just touches things up really nicely. Of course, you can go into different directions here just by hovering, or you can go into one of these categories. So let's say, you know, this is something that you like, you can go ahead and click more like this. This is generally how I work. I find a preset I like, I click on more like this, and then I hover over. Actually, this one I kind of liked a lot too. So, you know, sometimes I'll look to see who created it, and then I'll click on it to apply. And then I might go kind of with the strength slider. Actually, this looks kind of good, even stronger. Now, one of the most important things to remember about a preset is that you are not locked. Just because you apply the preset doesn't mean that you have to be done with your edit. It's just a way to either give you a starting point from as opposed to zero, or to give you kind of a creative impulse of a direction you should go. So for example, with this photo here, maybe I want to go ahead and, you know, open the exposure up a little bit more, go down to effects, reduce clarity. I can even use some of the adaptive masks if I want. But the point is that you are not locked into the preset just because you apply it. You can refine it however you want. And when you refine it, you can save it as your own preset as well. So again, this is one of those things about Lightroom that I love. It's a really powerful feature that's been hiding in plain sight. And there are actually a bunch of things like that. And if you want to learn all of those things, if you want to learn everything there is to know about how to use Lightroom on your desktop and your mobile devices, I really recommend you check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. And if you want to check out some more Lightroom editing videos, I've got this entire playlist that you should check out. And if this video has been helpful, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to click on subscribe and the bell icon to get notified for all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.